A very good morning to all my dear students. First of all, congrats to everyone for being promoted to class 9. Amid this coronavirus, COVID-19, so we are at home. So though we are at home, so we are still with the education. The education is with us. This COVID-19 will not leave us or depart us from giving the education. So first of all, be very much thankful for the principal of our school, for all the colleagues, as well as the staff management. So we are thankful, as well as you should be thankful for getting this opportunity, learning at home through online classes. So, the subject which I am going to teach is economics. So, it is a newer subject to you all. So, before starting the class, just I want to say, whatever topic is being explained, please go through it. Please understand each and every point clearly. I will be repeating it slowly. First explanation, again then I'll explain, again I'll repeat it. So that you understand in a much better way. And I'll be teaching in a much simpler way. Because it is a newer subject to you all, okay? So try to get some knowledge through it. Let us begin our chapter. So the chapter is a small summary. The chapter name is Definition of Economics. Here we will study the meaning and definition of economics. After that, we will study the definition given by the famous economist. Next, we will study about the micro and macroeconomics, two types of economics, that is, means Keynes, Professor Keynes. He said economics should be in this way, micro and macroeconomics. So we will study about micro as well as macroeconomics. After that, we will study about the types of activities, that is economic activities and non-economic activities. And at the last, okay, we will study about the sector of an Indian economy. Our Indian economy is divided into three sectors, that is primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. So these all things will be discussing in our today's class. So let's start. Yeah, come here. So here, introduction to economics. As I told you, the syllabus. Okay, definition of economics. Adam Smith. Okay, Leonard Robbins, Keynes, and Paul Samuelson. So these four famous economics definition we will be knowing and we will be learning. Micro and macroeconomics by Professor Keynes. Types of activities, that is economic activities and non-economic activities, and sectors in an Indian economy, that is economy. Okay, so let us see about the meaning of economics. So here, the word economics is derived from the Greek word oikos. Oikos means household. And nemen means management. So when we take together both oikos and nemen, means household management, so it refers to managing the household activities with a limited fund. See here, for management of the household, something is required. Yes, something is required. Money is required. Yes, money is required. So money means fund. So it refers to management of household activities with a limited fund. Okay. This definition was given by earlier economist. Okay. See here. It was derived from the two Greek words oikos, which means household, and nemen, okay, means management. Thus it refers to management of a household using the limited fund the how we'll manage the household activity. It is called as economics earlier. But generally when we speak to people, when we define economics in the present days, so how it is said here, economics is defined as the social science. It is defined as a social science that studies all economic activities. It is defined as a social science. Social science means it takes the complete society together. Means we have to study about society. What they are doing, what they are consuming, what they are producing, everything. That's why it is a social science. It studies all the economic activities. Economic activities means the activities which is done for the profit motive, means for earning of money and wealth, is termed as economic activities. Okay, now let's come to this point. Hope you understood this. See here, economics, one more time, I'm going to explain. Just see, listen here. It was derived from two Greek words. See the highlighted point, oikos, which means household, and nemen means management. Thus, it refers to management of a household using the limited fund. See, a limited fund means whatever money you have, with that only you have to manage. Whatever wealth you have, with that only you have to manage. It is called as limited funds. Understood? And next, economic is defined as the social science that studies economic activities. Understood? Okay. Next, Adam Smith. According to him, what is economic? He defined economic as an inquiry into the nature and causes of wealth of nation. He defined economic as an inquiry. As an inquiry into the nature, whatever, what is there in the nature and the causes of nation's wealth. Okay, and the causes of nation's wealth. Simply means he defines economic as the nature, means in the nature, okay, what is there and from how the resources will be coming out, means the wealth will take it out from the nature, okay, according to him. And one more thing, Adam Smith, he is called as the father of economics. Adam Smith is called as father of economic. Why? Because he was the person to first coin out in a much better way about the definition of economics. Okay, and this book, An Inquiry into the Nature. Okay, he, in his book, which was published in 1776, so he has explained it thoroughly. Okay, so next come to Leonel Robbins. So according to him, what is economics? So according to him, see here, economic is the science which studies human behavior. It studies human behavior, okay, as a relationship between ends and scarce means. Relationship between ends and scarce means, which have alternative uses. See, I highlighted the point. According to him, economic is the science. He also says economic is a science. Okay, earlier you have studied social science. So he is also saying economic is a science. It is a science which studies human behavior. Means the knowledge about human behavior. Okay, as a relationship between ends and scarce means. Means the study of the human behavior. What to study? The relation. What kind of relation? The ends and scarce means. Ends means how he is utilizing the available resources. Whether the particular person is wasting the resources or the particular person is utilizing the resources efficiently, means completely. Okay? Which have alternative uses. Means that resources can be used in much better way, in much alternative way also, in different ways also you can use. Okay? Like the electricity, solar energy is there, okay, hydroelectricity is there. If limited resources means hydroelectricity, limited resources, now there is a demand for electricity, energy. So the scientists, they have discovered solar energy. So through the solar panel, we are getting the energy of the sun. So that is called solar energy. So alternative way, that is called alternative way or uses. Okay, next come to Samuelson. According to Samuelson, economic is the study of how individual and society, how individual as well as society choose with or without the use of money, choose with also or without the use of money to employ scarce productive resources. Scarce productive means the limited resources, how that particular society or the person can use it in a much better way, okay, which could have alternative uses, that could be put into alternative uses also to produce various commodities, to produce various commodities over time and distribute them for consumption and distribute them for consumption now, okay, now and in the future, and in the future among people and groups of society, among people and groups of society. So according to Samuelson, see here the reason, Leonard Robbins and Samuelson, if you see properly, both they are trying to say the same definition, but in Paul Samuelson the description is lengthier and in Leonard Robbins the description is shorter, but then when you take out the meaning, both will be same. And okay, let me show how. See here, economy is the study of how individual and society choose with or without the use of money to employ scarce productive resources. Scarce here, scarce resources, ends and scarce means the resources, scarce productive resources which could have alternative uses, which have alternative uses means he is studying about human behavior and he is saying about individual and society. Okay, human behavior means society, they come in society only, interrelated. Okay, employ scarce productive resources, ends and scarce means same, which could have alternative uses, which have alternative uses. Further here describe, okay, why, what to do that resources. Of course, we'll produce the resources. Of course, we'll produce the resources. Okay, we'll produce resources now, okay, or over time, whatever time comes, and after producing the resources, what we'll do, what is the work, we'll keep it like this? No, we're not going to keep it this way, we are going to distribute it. But when you distribute, it can be now also, or it can be in the future also, now and in the future. But to whom to distribute? Whom to distribute? To the people, yes, to the people, and you can say to the group of society also. So this is what the definition of Paul Samuelson. Same, okay, even both of them, Leonard Robbins and Paul Samuelson, they are trying to say the same thing, but little bit the word are here and there according to their point. Okay, it is in three line, okay, as you can see here, but it is in much elaborate way. Just he described, okay, in much more detail. This is what Paul Samuelson. Next we'll come to Keynes. What he's saying, see here, according to him, economics is a study of administration. It is a study of administration. Administration means to control, to management, to look through. Okay, is a study of administration of scarce means. Of scarce means the population is growing day by day, the resources are becoming limited and limited. So that's why scarce means, how to manage those scarce means, how to manage those limited resources so that it can be used in much proper way, means without any wastage it can be used. It is called as scarce means. Okay, economic is a study of administration of scarce means and the determination of employment and income, and the determination of employment and income. Employment means getting job. Okay, after getting job, what will be there? Of course, people will get income. So he is saying same thing. It is a study of administration, control of scarce means, control of scarce means the limited resources, okay, and the determination and to determine whether okay job is there as well as the income. Understood? Moreover, he considers economic activities must be dealt with individual and a whole. He considers, so economic activities must be dealt with individual as well as whole. Individual means micro and whole means macro. So now we are going to learn micro and macro. So according to Keynes, so let us go through micro. See here, while studying micro, make sure you understand it. Micro, I should be given importance. I means individual. And while studying macro, A should be given importance. A means aggregate. Aggregate means total. Total means as a whole. So when you are learning the each word much proper way, clearly, if you are understanding it, then it is nothing to understand. If you understand it easily. So let's come to micro. So microeconomics, I means individual. So it studies behavior of small economic units. It studies the behavior of small economic units, means small part wise, particular, you can say, okay, particular, okay, economic units of an economy, okay, particular economic units of an economy, like individual consumers, individual producers, individual retailers, okay, etc. and so on. Understood? So it deals with mostly the individual theory, means the particular theory, studying about any particular thing, okay, not as a whole, but a particular thing is called as microeconomics. It studies behavior of small economic units of an economy, okay, like individual consumers, individual producers, etc. Okay, I stands for individual. When the economic system studies about the particular or individual thing, it is termed as microeconomic. Okay, as the definition says, it studies behavior of small economic units of an economy. Understood? Next come to macroeconomics. See here. Macroeconomics, it studies the aggregates of an economy. Aggregates of an economy. A, aggregates. Aggregates means total. Okay? So when we study the economic system as a whole, or economy as a whole, it is called as macroeconomics. Like the GDP stands for gross domestic product. Gross here stands for the total. So when we study about the total product being produced within the country, okay, we term it as a whole. So it is called as macroeconomics. Okay, we in macroeconomics we study economic as a whole, and in microeconomics we study economic individually, means particularly. Okay, like see here, GDP, national income, and so on. Okay, next we'll study about the difference between micro and macroeconomics. So what is the difference between micro and macroeconomics? See here, meaning, as already you have studied, same meaning. It studies behavior of small economic units of an economy. Okay, no need to write example, just that much only. Okay, macroeconomics, it studies the aggregates of an economy, or you can write, it studies economic as a whole. It studies economy as a whole, you can write in the meaning. Okay, see, what is the scope? What is the scope of micro and macro? So it is related to relative price of goods. Relative price of good means the particular price of good, means individual price of the good, means the price of one thing, one individual thing, not the whole item. Okay, like the price of the soap, the price of the Colgate, the price of the biscuit, these all things. Okay, prices. And it studies the aggregate price, the total price. Okay, total price means what is the cost of this whole cosmetic items. Okay, like if you say the cream, means creams of all the companies, it will come, everything it will come. Okay, divided. So average, so aggregate means total price it comes. Okay, so it studies the aggregate price of goods, means the total price. Tools, demand and supply of a particular commodity. So when the demand or and supply of a particular commodity fluctuate in the market, so it comes in microeconomics, means the demand and supply of a particular commodity. Demand and supply of a particular commodity, and here demand and supply of aggregate means aggregate commodity, means the total commodity. When we study about the demand and supply of a total commodity, okay, it will come in macroeconomics. Next, degree of aggregation, means aggregation means the totalness. Okay, as you know, in micro we study about individual, so you understood that the aggregation will not come. So the aggregation is low here. Aggregation will be low, and here the aggregation will be high. Aggregation will be high. Okay, so this is the difference between micro and macro. One more time, see here. Meaning, here as I told you, okay, it studies about the individual economic system and it studies economy as a whole. Meaning, scope, it study about the particular product, price of the particular product, means relative goods, and it studies, okay, aggregate price level of a commodity. Tools, demand and supply of a particular commodity, micro, and macro, demand and supply of a individual commodity. Okay, tools, demand and supply of a particular commodity, and in macro, demand and supply of the aggregate commodity. Okay, it won't be individual, sorry, it will be aggregate in macro. Degree of aggregation in micro, there will be low degree aggregation, and in macro it will be high degree of aggregation. Next, come to types of activities. What are the types of activities? As I have told earlier also, there are two types of activities, economic activities and non-economic activities. Economic activities, it is concerned with earning money and wealth. And non-economic activities, it is not concerned with earning money and wealth. It's much simple. When the motive is earning just profit, just benefit, it is called as economic activities. And when the motive is not to earn money, like doing any social work and all, helping the poor, needy and all, it is called as non-economic activities. See here, economic activities concerned with money and wealth, and non-economic activities not concerned with money and wealth. Understood? So difference between, so what is the difference between, okay, economic and non-economic activities? See here, objective, what is the objective? Main objective, okay, concerned with money and wealth, means main objective is to earn profit. Main objective is to earn profit, and non-economic activities objective is to do social work. Means it is not concerned with money and wealth. Okay? Types. What are the types here? Production, consumption, distribution. Okay, production, consumption, distribution, everything is related to earning money. Good produce, distribute, and at last consume. Free of cost. When you go in the market, okay, you purchase any item, do you get free of cost? No, you have to pay for it. Yes, you are paying for it. So it is called as your economic activities. And here, types, political, social, religious, Okay, these all are non-economic activities. When politician comes, they help any poor. It is called as non-economic activities. You go in the temple and all, do religious activities and all. You don't get any monetary benefit. Okay? Purpose. What is the main purpose? Satisfy material need. Satisfaction of the material wants. Satisfaction of the material want. It is called as the purpose. Okay? So after getting something, so when you are in need of getting some new dress, so when you get that particular dress, so you become happy, you satisfied. So that is what the satisfaction, okay, you get, means purpose. And it is done to get mental and psychological satisfaction. When after helping anyone, when you get the mental and psychological satisfaction, you get full satisfaction. Yes, I have helped someone, I have done a good work. Okay, means a mental peace is there. Then, okay, you are fully satisfied. Okay, it is the purpose. Your purpose is over. Purpose is over. Scope. What is the scope? It exists between employer and employee. Okay, producer, consumer, etc. Okay, employer and the employee, when the both are related. Okay, the worker and the staff. Okay, producer and the consumer. Okay, means a benefit is there. A monetary benefit is there. It is called as a scope. Next. So activities that take place between family member. Activities that takes place between the family member, relatives and all. It is called as, okay, here, non-economic activities, here, different scope. What is the main scope? It exists between employer and employee, or producer, consumer. And next, non-economic, the activities, good, which are between the family members, relatives, or friends and all, okay, it is called as, okay, here, non-economic. Our Indian economy. Okay, this is the last point we will be discussing. Indian economy. It divided into three sectors. Primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Primary sector is also called agriculture sector. Secondary sector is also termed as industrial sector. And tertiary sector is termed as service sector. One more time, listen here. Primary sector is called termed as agricultural sector, secondary sector is termed as industrial sector, tertiary sector is termed as service sector. So see here, explanation. Primary sector, just explanation will be needed. Okay, a thorough explanation is not required in this sector. So primary sector, goods are produced by exploiting natural resources. When we exploit the natural resources, okay, when we exploit the natural resources, it is called as primary sector. Okay, like farmer, they do cultivation when the plants are being cut. Okay, after the plants are being cut, so where they will go? Okay, they will not leave it as usual, so it will be sent to the industry. So, in the form of raw materials. It is called as secondary sector. The secondary sector is also termed as industrial sector. So when the raw materials will reach industry, so what will be there? It will be manufactured. It will be manufactured into the finished good. Means last item. Finished good. The goods will be, it will be go through the industry and it will be converted into the usable good. It is called as finished good. Okay, like the wheat, from the field the wheat will come, then it will be taken to the industry, and in the industry the wheat will be converted into flour, and with the flour different kind of items will be made, like biscuits and all, noodles and all, many different kind of items will be there. That biscuit, bread, noodles and all, they are the finished product. They are the finished product, and that biscuit and all, it will be coming in the market. How it will come to the market? Through transport service. Through transport service. This is the last sector, tertiary sector. Means industry, agriculture work is over, इंडस्ट्रियल वर्क इज ओवर, नेक्स्ट कम टू टर्शियरी सेक्टर मींस सर्विस सेक्टर मींस द सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड एग्रीकल्चर दे विल एक्सप्लॉइट नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज सेकेंडरी सेक्टर दे विल मैन्युफैक्चर नाउ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हुल डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हुल प्रोवाइड द सर्विस सो टर्शियरी सेक्टर here it produces the services. One more time, primary sector goods are produced by exploiting natural resources, activities relating to manufacturing and construction, and it produces the goods. Okay, so this is the three sectors of an Indian economy. Understood? So for today this much, and it is the end of your first chapter. Hope you have understood, and whatever explanation is there, so please go through it thoroughly, listen carefully, so that you will understand in much better way. And very soon I'll be providing the questions as well as I'll give the answers also, because okay, you will find it hard to find because you are newer to the subject. Okay, I will provide the answers to you all also. So, best of luck. Be safe. Thank you.